Hey guys,
Tom, White Filth. With another vinyl update. I have a co-host today. She's not feeling very vinylish, so don't expect too much.
I have a few records
that I'm going to show. It's all new in collection. Nothing label related this time. I hope you enjoyed the hypertension vid I did the last time. So this is all new in collection. I'm going to click a few buttons over here so I can give you some more info on the records. Let's start out with these guys. This is what I said in the previous video. These are five records I got at a record fair last week or the week before. They're all pretty much older records, but all in very good condition. First one is Burial Untrue on Hyperdub and Cargo Records. It's not an essential in the way for my collection, but I really love Archangel and Near Dark. Those are two of my favorite tracks from Burial, and it was €20. I got it from a friend of mine. It's an original, so I thought, why not pick it up? Because I kept putting it off to get it. It's on black, decent pressing, two tracks on each side, I think. Yeah, the D side has three tracks. But yeah, I guess everybody knows this record. There is no inserts or anything. And it has a little wear, but that's okay. It's still a great record. I've listened to it all true because I kept listening to Archangel and Near Dark. But yeah, first one, Burial Untrue. Put that there. This is Clio, by the way. Say hi.
Hi, people.
Yeah, she likes to sleep. Sometimes when I put on Wind Hand, the Violet Roadburn, she sings to me. But I don't have it here. Next up, I got this from Geert, a guy who was selling records at our booth at the record shop. It's the NWA Straight Outta Compton. What can I say? It's truly a classic. It's not the original, it's the 2002 repress with bonus tracks on the D side. Express Yourself, Extended Mix, 10 Bonus Beats, and Straight Outta Compton, the Extended Mix, AVAB. I don't know what that is. A bitch is a bitch, of course. That's with Snoop Dogg, I think. I'm not sure. Well, it's a gatefold of this awesome record. There they all are. Ren, Yella, Ice, Dr. Dre, they're all there. It is just on black, I think. I haven't played it because I know this record all too well. It's on Capital, Priority, and Ruthless Records. God damn the Ruthless. This is just, you know, it's a classic. And I kept putting off getting it because I wanted an original, but this is an original enough for me. Because I don't want to pay original prices. Also, those Dre releases, Chronic and Chronic 2001. I never got them. I got them on CD, but never on vinyl. And they're too expensive. I got this one from Ralph from Hypertension. Picked it out of the bin before it even started. This is In Gnat We Trust from Gnat. Gnat is a... It's one of those free bands. This is on Rocket Recordings. Backside is some more Pope, Made in England sticker. And it has two tracks on here, Tony's First Communion and Vatican, 2011. This is not original. The original was on white. This one is on a transparent purplish pink. I showed the triple records some videos ago. They're an interesting band. I'm not sure if I like it 100%, but I got this for some low price. So yeah, Gnaut and Gnaut Ultra still plastic. This was still sealed, so I don't think he ever listened to it. I don't even know why he had it. I don't know. This one I got from Jens, another guy who was helping selling our stuff at the venue. Fair. He has a label, Sparkblood, who is doing his second release right now and a third one coming up. When I have actual, I've shown the tapes, I think, from the first one he did with Dan from the exhibition we got in Amsterdam. But once I have some releases in house, I will do a profile of it on Sparkblood. But he has a Facebook page right now, and I think a page for or a big cartel or something is coming up. He fixed me this for $5. The unreleased soundtrack music from George A. Romero's Dawn of the Dead. It's kind of a crappy cover, but it fits the musical aesthetic, I think. It has quite a lot of tracks, 6 on side 1 and then 8 on side B. It comes with a extensive liner notes about the movie, and then when there's no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth. It's on Trunk Records. There you go, Trunk. And it's, yeah, unreleased soundtrack. He sold it to me for $5, but it's worth quite more on the old Discogs. It's a pretty good pressing for such a bootleggy looking cover. Two sides. It's quite a good pressing. It's not 180, but quite nice. Yeah, it's a cool thing to have, I guess. I'm not getting myself into soundtracks, because that will be the end of it. I have a few, but not that much. And then the last thing I got at the fair was the self-titled first album from Hella. Hella is a weird, noisy, angular rock band, known for the fact that it's Zach Hill on drums. Maybe this is him, I'm not sure. Zach Hill is now drummer extraordinaire for Dead Grips. He's more of a drum treasure than a drone, actually. Pretty good shape. I got it for $20, which is not cheap, but not really expensive. I haven't listened to all the way, but I like it. I like Helen. I like his solo work too, and I like Dead Group. So it's on Frenetic Records, San Francisco. There's the back. The insert is a nice print one. So yeah, cool record. Minimal edge one. This is from Dave, the drummer from the Evil Superstars. He gave it to me. I always get something from Dave each year because he has a lot of good stuff and good prizes. And then these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 records, just new ones I got. First one up is the new Battles, Ladi Dadi. I just buy it blindly. I don't know. I like Battles. I wasn't really into the Gloss Drop stuff, but the Mirrored and then the EP and the EEP and VEP were, or EEP and CEP, sorry, were awesome. And I just buy it blindly. Also, the artwork is always really cool. They stayed on the food, the glass drop and drop glass stuff with all ice cream and melted shit. And this is a various stages of breakfast, I think. It's nicely printed. This has a spot-on varnish. I don't know if you can see that. Then the gatefold. It's a little bit more eaten. And then on the back, the text is glossy. This is the last phase of the breakfast, I think. And it continues on the inner sleeves. So let's take it all out, because it's quite the package. It said this is the version you had to order from Warp directly, but I just got it at my local record shop, and it has all the goodies in here. So yeah, look at all this paper. So the inserts have the artwork continued to get dirtier and dirtier until it's a paste. It is a black vinyl, and apparently it's 140 grams. It's first edition, it says there, on the orange Hype sticker. I'm keeping it a little bit further because I noticed I cut off, in the Hype video, I cut off the bottom half of the records and the sleeves, so I changed venues for a bit more light because it's actually nice outside. It comes with a sticker sheet for what's worth, to paste on your school books, I guess. And then it had a poster, again with the artwork. There you go. A lot of trashed pancakes, bananas, and is that bacon? Yeah, bacon and eggs. And then the B-side, as it were, battles la-di-da. Yeah, still love that band. Great drummer, great pop tunes. I kind of miss the vocals, but hey. I saw them the first time I saw them at Abbey at Domino Festival, it blew my mind. It was the same year as I saw Sun for the first time, also at that festival. And it came with a bin, a little bit closer, Battles. So yeah, this is first edition Battles. Clio, let me put it here. Second new one is the Uncle Acid Night Creeper. Got this from Rise Above directly. Love the record. There's not much to say. It's kind of the same sound, but more down tempo, slower tracks. My absolute favorite is Melody Lane. Unbelievable track. Saw them live 2 weeks ago. Unfortunately, Rise Above keeps sending me busted records, you know, corner dings, it's cracked the top. I managed to get the with the Dead, Die Hard, and this one in Die Hard, so I will be selling this one, I guess, even if it's cracked. It's not that bad, you know. New record, they cost a lot of money, Rise Above, so they should really be on the lookout for that stuff. But the Die Hards will be coming in because they've been sending out. I got a message, they've been sending them out. This is the black, and this is also limited. They're all pretty limited. Good pressing. As always, Rise Above. There's nothing wrong with the quality of the package. So, yeah. Night Creeper, some cool printed inner labels. In Memoriam, there is a card in here with a tank list and some stuff about the devil, I guess. It's a double LP, but it's not a gatefold, so it's a just a one-sided open sleeve, and then it comes with a poster. It has lyrics. Yes, it has lyrics. Clamor Girl Body. Yep. So it's in the same vein, but I don't know, something changed, but I'm not sure. I can't can't put my finger on it for now. But yeah, Uncle Acid, still a great band. Live, they were really good. They played at Melody Lane, was the first encore they did. And they did two more, which was unnecessary, but that's more my preference than the band's fault. Then, we're almost through this. I went to see Josef van Wissem. This guy, he is a, well, in Dutch it's called a luit. It's a 30-string guitar, a medieval instrument. Here it is, this one. I went to see him in Luik, and it was an incredible performance. He did the soundtrack for Only Lovers Left Alive from Jim Jarmusch, and he played along with the Images, plus it was on a boat. I wasn't planning on buying records, but after the gig, I got the two he plays together with Jim Jarmusch. The first one is Concerning the Entrance into Eternity. This one is on Important Records. Two guys on the back. And I got the ones with Jim Jarmusch because I thought they would be a little bit more guitar driven instead of the medieval sound. I like the medieval sound, but I have to get myself into it, and I was very interested in the Only Lovers Left Alive sound, because it was also more rock oriented than medieval just lute tunes. Very good pressing on black. This should be available, I think. The first one. It's all quite in the same style. You have to see him live. He's incredible. He walks through the crowd. It's, you know, it's great. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tracks. It says he plays a 13-course swan neck baroque lute, recorded in the fall of 2011. Yeah. Getting into these guys, Jim Jarmusch is mad too. Squirrel? Yeah. I ordered the third one. I'm looking for the first and the second one. They make some great music. The second one I got was another collaboration, Josef van Wissem, featuring Jim Jarmusch, Apokatastasis. Great artwork. Get it out. It's in plastic even more because it's a screen printed. It is a screen printed silver on black cardboard. He had some more stuff, but they were 20 a pop, so I got the two I like best. I haven't really checked this one out yet, but it's in the same vein because they share song titles also. Yeah, this is Apokatastasis. Restoration is on this one, is the first track, and this is the Apokatastasis. 7 tracks. Apocalypse Revealed, Apocalypse Explained. So yeah, it's basically the two of them making noise. Drawing is by Walter van Halmees. I think he's a Belgian designer who did a lot for Shark label magazine and stuff like that. He always has these beautiful medieval inspired line drawings. So check that out if you're into that. I haven't heard from him in a long while. I haven't seen, but I don't think Shark magazine is still around. So. Too bad. It was a great free magazine. So yeah, Josef van Wissem, Jim Jarmusch, the Only Lovers Left Alive soundtrack I showed in a collection bit, I guess, is re-released on ATP Records. So second press, Blood Red, just the same as the first one, I guess. And I should jump on it if you want some great tunes. Next up, I went to see Chelsea Wolfe & Low in Brussels, and it was a double bill. So they should have played equal sets, but Chelsea Wolfe was way too short. Way too short. Plus, for the first time in the AB, there was a really crappy sound. Something was wrong with the speakers. Which wasn't wrong when Low played, so... I don't know. I got the Live at Roadburn. Finally, this is second or third press maybe already. Chelsea Wolfe mix of shoegaze swirls and satanic swamp rock stomp is totally irresistible and trawling. Everybody knows Chelsea Wolfe by now. She's our PJR, I would say. This is on Smurf Blue. Doesn't matter what color it is, actually. I think it's second or third pressing. I was at this show, and it was a really, really good show in the green room, and it was something different at the time for the Roadburn crowd. She had her second record out by that time. It was 2012. So, yeah. The new record was also very, very good. Chelsea Wolfe, I think first press and stuff like that is all sold out, so I had to get that one. Then two more, two kind of, you know, companion records. The first one is Don't Deliver Us from Satan Satyr, Kalei Satana's band. And once again, look at this beautiful cracked sleeve. It's a very good record, I think, if you're into that fuzzy stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 records. It's on Bad Omen, 9 tracks on Bad Omen Records. Cool looking cover with their faces and the lettering. And then here are the guys when the gate was still standing. I think the metaphor is they busted the gate. This is the pre-order version, the limited one on white. I think they're 80 or something. There you go. Cool printed inner labels, Bad Omen 13. And there you go. Satan Sage here, Don't Deliver Us. Yeah, it's fuzz. He's the Clay Thomas, or what is his name? Clayton Burgess. Yeah, but his metal name is Clay Thomas. He's the bass player now for Electric Wizard. So you can see where they get their fuzz stuff. They didn't start out as a Blue Cheer cover band, but the first time I saw them live, it was a Blue Cheer cover set. So it's in that vein. It's 70s worship ish. There we go, big blood moon on the back. So yeah, the last one, I was waiting a long time for this one. This is Fuzz 2 on Indoret. This is a brand new record, 2015. If you've seen my other videos, you know I'm into Fuzz. And I had to get this one too. Nice gatefold, crappy looking shed. Phantom of the Opera, apparently. Phantom of the Opera Worship. This is the Rough Trade exclusive. Here it is, the Indoret sticker. Printed inserts with the guys, Mr. Thijs de Gaulle. And I like the, it's really sturdy cardboard. It's a good release, actually. Costs a lot of money. Here, my paper hands are meaningless. I'm wandering deep. I feel like a maggot, but I like it. Flashy snacks and wandering jeeps are meaningless. Jeeps or jeeps? I'm not sure. Yeah, the bag is black, and the inserts are. Here's the last one. looking guy. As I said, this is the Rough Trade exclusive. It's on mint green. It's kind of a marble with blue and white. It is a good record. It's just more of the same. It's just as catchy as the first one. Just as... Well, heavy is not the right word because it's heavy in a different way. It's bop heavy, I would say. Yeah. But yeah, really love the record. Really, really love the record. So that's plus two Ty Segall. And this is going for quite some money already, so I was looking at the gold one on in the red, but that was gone before I could even click on PayPal. So this is just as good. Fuzz, number two. Last record. Oh, that's nothing. So yeah, those were the records. New in the collection from the record fair and just orders I did online and at the local record shop and gigs. The next one coming up will be a new in collection too, from mostly from gigs I did. So yeah, I hope you still like the videos. I've seen the numbers grow, so seems people like them. If you have questions, comments, you know, want to see anything, just let me know. I'm going to take a nap here, and I'll see you next time. Thanks a lot, man. Bye.